Piscarpiological Complex. The Piscarpiological Complex is one of the major population centers of the Incas in the Sacred Valley and was probably built as a royal estate by the Inca Paco Cutac. It consists of terraces and ceremonial and domestic structures. It has an impressive Intihuatana. The Piscarpiological Complex is located approximately 18 kilometers northeast of Cusco, 33 kilometers by road, near the town of the same name. This is one of the major population centers of the Incas in the Sacred Valley. It was probably built as a royal estate by the Inca Paco Cutac. Although this was not strictly speaking a fortress, it played an important defensive role thanks to its privileged strategic location. In particular against the Antis, a people of the jungle subdued decades earlier by the Inca Capac Yupanqui. The complex is located on top of a hill and has a spectacular view over the valley of Urubamba and the town of Pisc, located on its banks. It is surrounded by two rivers, Guatemala on the west and Chongo on the east. As it was the custom, the Incas built the city on a pattern representing an animal, in this case, a partridge, Paisaca in Quechua. Pisc is composed of terraces and domestic and ceremonial structures. It is divided in several sectors, the terraces, Canchisrake, the Tancanimarca Inca Cemetery, Calacasa, Tianic, Intihuatana, Paisaca, the deposits or calcas, the city walls and the Amirapunku door. In Pisc, there are 16 agricultural sectors with advanced platform systems, also named terraces. They have some of the most impressive and beautiful walls, made of huge and perfectly polished blocks. The most impressive terraces are located north of the complex. The terraces located east of the resort and those located at less altitude, southwest of the complex near the town of Pisc are also remarkable. The Canchisrake sector, also called Canchisrake, is located near the northern main entrance, at the top of the resort, out of the fortified city. It consists of numerous buildings of mud and rough stone called Burka. There are also buildings called canches that served as rooms for people cultivating the nearby platforms. There are also some remains of aqueducts and fountains. This sector is ideally placed to monitor the movements of people in the valley located under the complex. The path continues in direction of the valley and passes on top of spectacular terraces. On the opposite side of the hill, separated by the Guatemala Creek, you can see the Tancanimarca Inca Cemetery. It is a true necropolis measuring about 100 meters high and several kilometers wide. According to estimates, it must have contained about 10,000 tombs, mainly plundered by Spanish conquistadors. Indeed, the Incas, believing in reincarnation, buried their dead with all their belongings, jewelry, metals, precious stones, etc., for their new life. Today, you can still observe the tomb's holes in the hill. Following the path to the Intihuatana sector, comes the Calacasa sector, consisting of a series of rustic constructions with irregular forms. They may have housed permanent workers who cultivated the land around the complex. After passing through a tunnel, you will reach Tianic, located at the top of the Intihuatana sacred area and that consists of buildings arranged around a small square. Intihuatana is the most important sector of the complex. It consists of buildings made of finely carved rectangular stones. In most of them, you can see typical Inca niches. The most important is a building shaped like the letter D surrounding a huge rock carved in a special way. This altar is also known as Intihuatana. It may have served to hold religious ceremonies and for astronomical observations. Under the Intihuatana sector you can find 6 calcas or Inca deposits. The Paisaca sector is a set of rectangular buildings distributed to form an arch. The walls of these buildings are amazingly perfect. There is also a construction similar to a viewpoint from where you will have a perfect view over the valley and the town of Pisc. Going back to the point of beginning of the visit, but on the eastern side of the hill, you can see remains of the city walls, which had 5 gates. The only gate that still has its lintel is called Amirapunku or Gate of the Serpents. Pisc is sometimes called the City of Towers. There are over 20 of them built in the leading edge of the mountain, but it is difficult to establish with certainty which role they played.